people is to celebrate Gandhi Jayanti. And whenever I looked at the photo of Gandhiji, something was attracting me. The personality itself was attracting. Here is such a simple man, wearing a khadi, dhoti, and a shawl. How did he chase the Britishers and won freedom for our country without firing a single bullet? That is the greatest achievement. And I used to wonder how. History says kings, emperors, Alexander and all that, they used to go for war and win kingdoms. Here is one simple man, very frail, and that is when I started studying Gandhi, my experiments with truth. And I realized that at the same time my spiritual search has also started. That is when I realized spiritual power is the ultimate power. When a person like Gandhi single-handedly, and his two weapons, non-violence, ahimsa and satyagraha, no AK-47, no tanks, no fighter jets, simple ahimsa, satyagraha, non-violence and satyagraha is fast. And with these two things, he could bring about a revolution which no individual has done in the history of mankind. If you study the history, you will not come across a person, a personality like Gandhiji. And his whole technique was, again, meditation. Spiritual meditation. And spirituality became his weapon. And nowhere in the history as an individual has used spiritual power for political activism. That is the greatness of Gandhiji. And another important thing is, he said, we can bring about a revolution among the whole country without any weapons. Can you imagine in this present context, we are spending billions of dollars on buying weapons. Ironically, we are buying weapons. But here is one man who brought us freedom, who is the father of our nation. We all look up to him with a lot of respect. Even today, the word Gandhi itself invokes an immediate utmost reverence that such a wonderful human being guided us towards freedom, political freedom. And all his experiments with truth is again revolutionary. Is fast unto death, satyagrahas, all he has used and his breathing techniques. In fact, there was a conversation between, I have read it in autobiography of a yogi. Okay.
Paramahamsa Yoga.
Paramahamsa Yoga. He goes to meet Gandhiji and he is in Maunavrata. So he writes, and Yogananda ji says, here is spiritual activism, a karma yogi. He is not a yogi who is sitting in the Himalayas and meditating. he is meditating among the people for a cause, for the freedom of our country. And he writes notes because he was in silence, mauna. So he answers all this. Those interactions are amazing. And all of you should read that. Gandhiji should become like, you know, my experiments for truth should be the basic education for all the children, of school children of our country. Because people have lost touch with Gandhiji. So these principles of non-violence, satyagraha and spirituality. I would say he was a spiritual guide, spiritual political activist, which nobody has done. And without firing a single bullet, he could bring freedom to our great country. So saying these few words, I think we should read Gandhiji at least one page every day. His history, his autobiography, that is the way we can bring about inspiration within ourselves to be better citizens. And we have to involve ourselves in the political, social governance of our country. It is not just reading and keeping it in the library, no. We should make it as our life force. These are the few points which I would like to highlight. And this should be spread all over our country through school. Not college, school, primary school. Make this Mahatma Gandhi, yes, this is the Atmakate, that is autobiography. In English also it is there. That is my experiments with truth. Should be the syllabus, compulsory syllabus to all students. So within this we can bring about a social and spiritual revolution that will again bring qualities of spiritual values in our great country. So saying these few words, I would like to end my story.